Welcome. I'm going to show you a folder hack that every Power BI developer needs to know. The trick about it is that it's not native to Power BI Desktop. Here's the problem. Within Power BI Desktop, all you can do is organize all your measures, all your columns, whatever you have in your model under a single folder like this. What I'm going to show you how to do is to how to have an unlimited ability to nest and create as many folders as you want using something that's external from Power BI Desktop, but it's totally free and easy to set up. And at the end of it, you'll be able to create something like this, where you can organize measures, columns, whatever you want in multiple folders across multiple levels. So let's dive into Power BI Desktop. If you find this helpful, hit subscribe, hit like, leave a comment, ask a question, and I'll keep sending Power BI information out to you. Now let's dive into Power BI Desktop. Let's go. All right, so here we are in Power BI Desktop, and where we're going to focus for this video is on the right-hand side. Now let's look. In this example, we have calculations, which is just a grouping of various calculations. There might be other tables, sales, whatever you want to have in your model. Now the goal of this video is by default, you know, it looks like this, where we have, say, calculations, a bunch of calculations. If we go into our model, then we can assign them on the right-hand side to a folder. And I could say display folder sales. Okay, but what if I wanted to organize these under sales into multiple folders to give some organization to the model? It's especially important if you're building a semantic model for other people to connect to. You just can't do it intuitively with Power BI Desktop. What that will look like is something like this. You know, we're going to build something like this. I'm going to show you how to hack this. Again, it's something that everybody needs to know. So on the right-hand side, here's an example of something that is organized with region calcs. I'm going to expand those. I can see East Coast, Middle America, West Coast. Let's expand West Coast. Okay, Far West or Southwest. Boom, here's Southwest, here's Far West. You can organize things as much as you want. As you can see, you can build multiple hierarchies. It's extremely valuable for organizing your model. Taking a step to organize it helps you build faster. It helps other people use it. If you end up having big, long collections of measures or even columns, it can get confusing. And so you need to always bucket your columns, bucket your attributes into folders. And again, these don't all have that, and that's out of best practice. So I'm going to show you how to do it, which is intentionally. So how do we do this? Boom, Tabular Editor. It's completely free. The version that's to Tabular Editor 2 is open source and completely free that will allow you to edit the data. I'm going to show you how to do it. It's extremely simple. So what you're going to want to do first is go to this URL and or search Tabular Editor version 2, submit your email, download it. It's a free program. After you install it, you'll probably reboot your computer. And then under external tools, you'll see it show up here. And there's lots of cool tools out there. ALM Toolkit, Bravo Dex Studio, Tabular Editor, which we're gonna talk about today. Editor 3, a commercial version of it. But Tabular Editor is all you need. It's completely free. So you install it, it shows up. Now I'm gonna click it, I'm gonna open it, but I'm gonna do this in split screen so we can see how they work together. So click Tabular Editor now, boom. And here we are, split screen. Tabular Editor on the right-hand side. This is what it's going to look like when it shows up. And again, this is extremely easy. It's such a cool tool. So now let's look. Let's do an example. So for the sake of just learning, say we want to bucket these rolling totals into groups. Like here's the net sales. We'll put the units together and we'll kind of start doing that. So all you'll need to do is in the model now in Tabular Editor on the right-hand side, go to tables. And now this is going to equate to exactly what shows up in your model. They automatically link up. Now we're going to go to this case, we're talking about the calculations. And now under rolling total, very simply, click what you want to add, right click, create new folder. I'll call this units. And then I'll do one, I'll call this net. And then we'll leave these three out just for the sake of it. So now we've updated the folder that easy. Maybe also you don't want to right click. You can just create a folder and start dragging and dropping. So maybe I'll put this into here. maybe even want to go deeper, where I'll just make a new folder for the sake of it called SuperNet, though it doesn't make total sense, but just the concept of it. And we'll move this net sales into SuperNet and then this under here. Very easy. You can drag and drop stuff. And then all you need to do is up here in the top corner, click Save Changes to the Connected Database, and we'll just watch. This will update automatically. Boom. That's simple. Now, all the calculations, here's the units, here's the SuperNet, and you can see if you go now and look at it, it will actually show up in here, and it has, you know, the display folder kind of typed out like this, but that will work. You can't just create it yourself is what I found. This will create it. But now say you're in here and we've just added this SuperNet, and let's make a new measure for the sake of it. Maybe we'll add it in rolling total. We'll just call it fake measure equals one. And we put it here, but now we want to move it. So firstly, we can see really quick, it shows up right over here on the right-hand side. They're completely linked. So if you wanted to, I could just easily drag it. But since you've already created the structure that's nested, you can now move this into deeper levels like fake net, and it will just automatically update it. So again, it's extremely important, because what can happen is you want to have users and other developers, or even yourself with your own model, have an easy ability to go to columns within your model and not get lost. If all these calculations were not bucketed, there's 50 some calculations here, it would be impossible to read. The more folder, the more structure, the better. So even this, look, this is called units total, units net. Well, how about all this stuff for units? Let's bucket all these together. That should really happen. So now, on the right hand side, and again, I'll upload this file so you can play with this as well if you don't have your own model, and you can get it from the description of this video. But now let's go over here. I'm going to click all these: units total, units return, units sold, units total, this one, create new display folder, we'll call this units, save. Look at that, much region calcs, rolling total, sales, units. That much easier. It helps navigate your model. It keeps things organized. This hack, you can go as deep as you need to go. It will equip you to be able to organize your model, get after it, use it, go the extra 5 minutes to organize your columns and organize your measures. It used to just be on calculation-based tables, but now you can do the same thing on any table. You know, maybe if we look at sales, just for an example of kind of best practices here, we'll go to the sales table. So I just see all these IDs. I'm just gonna first do this ID, and then we'll do, for now, we'll just do other again. And then you could do, this is not the best folder structure idea, but it's an idea of how you can make quick nested folder structures where you should organize these with intentionality, like I've done. Say, oh, I hit save. Boom, just shows up. That easy. Finally, if we look at an example of intentionally organizing something, well, let's look at the region calcs. And again, East Coast, Middle, West. Boom, boom, boom. I can now see, okay, well, how about I'm just caring about Great Lakes? We can go here and find it. Again, that's the gist. That's the hack. Use it. If you find this valuable, subscribe, like, share, leave a comment, ask any question. Let me know what you want to see. Thank you all so much. Have a good one. Bye.